you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Texas Southern Tigers and the Arizona Wildcats.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Wildcats should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Dick, as they're highly favored on paper. But what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. First of all, I look at the point guard to step up tonight and really take control of his club. Second, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. And finally, keep it simple defensively and play as a unit.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. They go into the low block.
And the fans love it. Jump with joy, man. Hey, that's my guy's yelling.
They move it into the front court.
High post screen, gonna use it?
It sticks.
That deserves an encore. Let's watch it here.
Down inside for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Defensively down the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
He better get rid of it. Let's it fly. Off the rim and no good. The point guard gets the ball. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. For two.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
Now trying to feed the low block. There's a double team waiting there. The shot from the baseline. Way off target. Knapp is pretty fired up and excited.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
Dick, it's really been a while since I've seen a team shoot like this.
Hey, every once in a while you get a squad that gets on a tear and simply makes your jaw drop. It's fun to watch, isn't it, Brad?
The center with the ball.
That's basic.
Has a nice look at the basket. He attempts the trifecta. Scorches the net. This crowd will go crazy if they get a shot to go down here. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Goes up for two. In and out.
Hey, Brad, a stop here will definitely raise the decibel level. Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Gave it up. Trying to feed the low block. Kicks it out. Unloads. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Nice shot. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot. High post screen.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Defense playing up. Mitchell pump fakes. Tries for two. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'd be in trouble without him.
For the bucket. They still don't score. Locks it. perfectly executed. Shot clock is dead. On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket, and in and out. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
From way downtown. Can't put it down. The ball goes out of bounds. At the end of the first half, the Tigers are down by eight. Showed no signs of rust with their shooting in the first half, Dick.
They certainly did. Their offensive execution was near perfection. Keeping it up will be the key.
All right, Dick, we're going into the second half, and, you know, this gets down to somebody's going home and somebody gets to play on.
Right, isn't that a shame, Brad, because both these clubs are playing so well. They're such quality teams. But it's going to come down at the end. I think you better be able to convert on that free throw line, and you got to get some easy baskets. I think every basket has been a struggle offensively. They got to find a way to get some conversions in transition.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Both teams looking to get things going here. Dumps it in. The center takes the pass. Tries for two.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he rushed.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
It's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Tries for two. Doesn't go. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat, the message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Off the rim and no good. Down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression. There's the trap.
Shoots. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
Gave it up. The center gets the pass. Jump hook from the low post. Rims out.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Almost lost the basketball. Shannon is fired up and ready to go.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from long range. He gets it to fall. Now the kick out. The power forward takes the feed. The ball goes out of play. Well, Mr. Vitale, let's take a look at our backcourt production.
Hey, I'll tell you one thing, Brad. You look at the stats, you want to find out if your backcourt is playing well. Well, you want to ensure that your guards keep the number of turnovers down. That's a must. Reduce turnovers. So many games are won and lost by teams turning the ball over. Turnovers, missed opportunities happen, baby, when you turn the rock over.
Now the high screen. On the dribble, gives it up. For three, he can't get the bucket to fall. Mitchell handles the pass. Jumped in front to take it away. For the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
And the ball goes out of play. Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I'll tell you one thing. Coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose the air and you get balled like I am.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you got to win it. Keep on going. We're going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I'll tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Arizona played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nestler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.